Okay, so homework six solution, I asked you to do a couple things. I asked you to add to the bottom of the blog page how long ago we ran the query. And if we reload this page, we can see this time incrementing. And I also asked you to do this on permalink pages. So if I were to look on a particular permalink, I can see the age of its query. And I can also tell when I create a new post, create this new post, and when I submit it, I get redirected to a permalink page whose query time increments. And when I go back to the front of the blog, I see my post on top with a nice new low query time. And finally, I asked you to implement a URL that clears the cache. In mine, I called it flush, which just redirects right back to blog, but it resets the cache, which causes the query to run again. So that's what I asked you to do, and now let's take a look at the code. Okay, so the couple things I needed to do, I needed to use time delta and date time to help compute the age of my posts. And I also needed to import memcache to cache things. Now, I added a bunch of functions that are kind of handy. I added this one function called age set, which basically is a wrapper on memcache set, but instead of setting just the value, it looks up the current time using date time UTC now. And it stores that time along with the value in a tuple. And then I made another function called ageGet, which what this does is it's just like memcacheGet, but it returns both the value and the age of the item as a tuple. So first thing we do is we run the memcacheGet on just the key. If it exists, the value and the time we saved it are in R, and so we break those apart. And then we compute the actual age in seconds, which is we take the current time minus the time we saved it, and we can call total seconds on that, which is a function that's included on time delta. Otherwise, if there was nothing in the cache, we just set value, val, and age to be none and zero respectively, and then we return them. So these are just handy functions, and I use them a couple places. Now, I've got a function that I run every time a new post gets submitted. And so this stores the post in the database, and it takes an IP parameter, which is unused. I used to use this IP parameter on my previous anti-spamming version, so that you guys could still submit to the blog and see it working, but it wouldn't store it in the database. I was actually just storing it in memcached. And I got rid of that. Now you just have to be logged in as me to submit to the blog. It runs this getPosts function, which is defined here, and this basically does the database query with update equals true. You saw me do this in the lecture. This is my technique for basically overwriting the cache with the new value. Now, there's still race conditions. Remember, we spent a lot of time talking about gets and casts. I didn't use those here. And then it returns the ID. Get posts, this is the function that actually runs the database query for me. You saw me write something like this for ASCII-CHAN, and here it is in the blog. This is my query. I'm using the procedural language again to look up all the posts. This is still an extra variable that's in there. I don't remember why. Code grows organically like that sometimes. Here's the memcache key I'm using. I'm just calling it a string blogs. I usually store the memcache key I'm using in a variable, because especially when I'm referencing it multiple times, so in case I want to change it or, you know, just to avoid typos, that sort of thing. It's a good habit to get into. So first I call ageGet, which does the memcache lookup for that key and gives me the posts and the age. And if update is true or posts is none, so basically if update is true or the posts aren't in the cache, run the query and then set it to set MC key to the value posts and then return the age. I've added another function called ageStir, which basically takes an age, which in this point is a floating point of seconds, and it returns the string replaced queried, you know, 0 seconds ago, 1 second ago, that sort of thing. So it converts it to an integer. If the value is one, we replace seconds with second, so it's, you know, grammatically correct, and then we return that string. And I use this function in my templates to print that string at the bottom of my pages. And on my blog's front page, I call getPosts. Remember, this returns the posts and the age. And I pass in the age to my template. I convert age, and I run the ageStir function on it, so I can include it in my template. And then on the permalink page, we do something similar. We cache each request. So this is the key for a particular post. It's just the string post with post ID. I usually prepend, when I'm looking up by ID, I usually prepend a string to the memcache key, so that if I want to change it later, I can just basically change this string and everything expires. We check to see if that post is already in the cache, and if it is, we have the age. If it's not, we have to look it up from the database, and that's how we do it. and then we set it to the cache, and we set the h to 0, and then I return the permalink HTML, which takes, my template now takes an h parameter, which is that h string. So that's all the changes there. I'll show you the templates really quick. Front.html just has a new class at the bottom called h, and that includes that h string that was passed in. And permalink HTML has the same thing at the bottom, a class called h with that string that we passed in. And in our CSS file, I added one little thing to the bottom, which is this age class, and this says position absolute, which basically says position this anywhere. 0 pixels from the bottom, 0 pixels from the right, make it gray, and make the font size 12 pixels. So that's how I put it down in the lower right. Obviously, we're not going to grade for that, but that's just how I did it. And that's the solution to homework 6. I hope you figured it out on your own.